jungle and starting his farm path there. That will leave the lane totally open for Ferev to be farming on his Timbersaw. Yeah, so.
First blood. I accept this honor on behalf of Storms everywhere.
Here and there, so they are still matching out pretty evenly. Dubu already guarding out the rune. He'll grab it himself. That prompts the dust, prompts the X into a torrent. Oh, Dubu waiting for the rune, but Secret were waiting for an opportunity to catch him waiting. I think. That sounded confusing. Yeah. Oh, it's now caught between three. The spear's going to come out. He's going to be able to get it done. Now looks for Puppy here. It's a lot of burn damage. He would definitely need maybe another couple. Is it good enough? Is it good? Is he roasting? Is he toasting? Is he burnt? He's burnt. Oh, that sounded painful. All right. Puppy goes down, and suddenly the game's back even. 3-3.
I'd hack you down again if I...
Now, Ferev, though, he also goes down. Ryzen's able to kind of blast him apart with the help of the Purifying Flames. Then they quickly focus onto him. King Chase blast flying through. It's a puny little blast, but it's good enough to be able to add that extra bit of peppering damage. Midwan will get the last. Yeah. Comes with that, and, like, I would imagine the armlet buildup. And, well, he's got a battle sooner than he wants, though, as he gets caught in the bad side of a call. Both just fly through, though, so does the dunk. And that's going to get Bellnab, but here comes Ferev looking to make the jump on the Febby. Thinking of jumps, there's QO moving on in, looking to go for MP. The brightest light ever blocking my screen right now, but there goes QO. False Promise is going to hit up, and Pi has to run on back. But that burn so hard, will it be enough for the takedown? Well, yes it will. Well, one last right click to get it from Febby. Meanwhile, Ferev will get that finish onto Huskar. A 3-10 down south. Look for opportunities. They know that they need to kind of be able to begin to take tier ones and control these fights, but oh my god. Alright, well, they're dead for sure, and this is going to be Secret in the corner now. Kibo's stuck in a bit of an awkward spot, but here comes a jump from Febby. 10 seconds, though, before Kibo's going to be up. Ferev happy to dance right through him, but with the Spears continuing to chunk on out, they'll be able to burn through the Timbersaw and take him down. Alright, that's a nice nab, but losing both your supports to start things off, unfortunately doesn't make it good. But he's looking to spin now, and they'll eventually get the burst on the pie. Now Febby on the run. Ferev not done yet. Looking to rush on in, and okay. What happened there? Purify Flame gets bursted up. It looked like he would deal with Fate's Edict, but just here they are looking to go on the offensive once again. Kyo needs to be careful here. Look at that. Offensive setup from Pi, bumping back with the blinding light. Allows Ferev to shred on forward here. QO gonna be going down. And they make it look effortless, and they will just... The problem is they have so much trouble with these four, as the boat flies forward, and Ferev just does utter destruction. The boat also connects, the Q-Bow will get the False Promise. He's going to try to do his damage to stay alive, but look at him! Caught in a chakra, too much damage! He is down for sure. MP has shown himself in the fight, and he said that, "You had to worry about the rest of my team, but I am finally here to play." And he squares up, gets a nice cute. Wow. Torrent to chain through, to jump in from. Unless Dubu Heads up this way. Looks like we could have some action. Puppies and Viz, but he has a tree. Spot out Dubu. They're going to pop the dust. They move on in. Bevy shows himself. Can't decide if he wants to pop out the Chrono Devil. Go for the time. Dialation. Then pops out the Chrono. Looking to go for mid one. Kilo jumps from the below ground. But man, Torrent and the boat and the black hole coming out. Sneaks going for their own response. The false promise will be there for QO. How much damage he'll be able to get up though? Is he going to be able to climb? He's good. Stays alive. Looks one. Blast continue to chunk out though for Pi. And Ferev brings in the deeps with the double kill now. They get through four. They're going for Fetty to make it five. With the mana leak, he may not be getting away. He goes down. That's all five out. They only get mid one MP. But that leads to two and blast, but no boat connection there. Fevy jumps back out in a way, but it's focused on Ferev here as he jumps way behind the MVP team. They're going to be able to get the call off. Self Lotus, but there's going to be the Chrono only to hold Ferev and to keep the ups back, I suppose. But nonetheless, it gets finished for them. This is ambitious. Very ambitious for MVP. Because Secret, as mentioned, are back and they're moving. Bell with no mana to work with. And Fevy with no Chrono. Okay. To the high ground. We've seen this before. Fevy a bit above, but Husk held up down. So, thank goodness. But this false promise. How lit is going to be? Eating some damage now. This triple top. Wolf able to slice down Ryzen, takes him apart. Q costs 20 rest to Secret. That's going to lead to the Roach. I don't think MVP are going to be holding on this game too much longer.
Immortality is mine!
Man, he lost like half his life from Pi's blast alone. And sure enough, Puppy will be behind him to catch him with the X. We'll have to see. MVP. Oh man, did this spotted pilot had a blinding light and just pieced out there. Fred knows what's happening. He just walked right into it, but turns in the middle, grabbing up Dubu, gets sliced up from Ferev. Solo with a jump in. They'll follow it up with the Chrono. A lot of hate here to get mid line. That's all for the Aegis. We'll bump back Quelling. As they run back in, a blink out MP on the back end of a pulse. Can he make it away? He's good. Now it's going to be on to Velo here. A jump in from Midwan. Meanwhile, Ferev cleaning up elsewhere. And then they get the cleanup on the rise. And Ferev with a triple. Probably the final say for MVP as they clean house a full five-man wipe. Secret lose. No.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's bottom tower. Dire's bottom barracks are under attack. Dire's bottom barracks has fallen. Dire's bottom barracks has fallen. Team Secret.
He is the greatest person, to be honest with you. I mean, it's PP. MVP going out in MVP fashion. In game number three, they see the opportunity to go pretty much all in. The Husk are fifth pick draft. Something that Secret have anticipated and prepared for. I mean, big play, it certainly seems so. But unfortunately for this